She was on living. You see what I'm saying? See, Gordon B said, keep on living. And then I had a great auntie, Fanny Mitchell. I used to always, when I come back home, I used to go and sit down and talk to her after grandmama died. And she would say, just keep on living. You see what I'm saying? Because the proof of the process is the evidence of the living. You see what I'm saying? If you ain't went through nothing yet, just keep on living. Just like she just said, we all get a turn. Nobody is going to, you might get by for a little while, but you'll never get over it. And that's why I'm so grateful for this process. And see, the Bible, I love this thing right here. I'm kind of feeling bad about the fact that I haven't used it like I need to, but this is the basic instructions before leaving Earth. It's spelled B-I-B-L-E. You see what I'm saying? It don't work if you don't use it. It don't work if you don't use it. And see, what I like about it is the words in the book don't change. Now, I'm subject to feel some kind of way at any time. But this confirms the fact that I cannot afford to act on how I feel. See, the truth is the truth, and God's word is the truth, and he stands on the truth. You see what I'm saying? God is so awesome that he tells us the whole story. You know, if you want to go forward to see what's on getting ready to go down, just go to the book of Revelation. You see what I'm saying? Someone was smart at it. Now, I just didn't believe it was going to end like that. But the sign of the times are here right now. Because the world is turning against the word of God. They're trying to justify and rationalize all kind of outrageous situations. And the scripture does not support what the world is condoning. So it's up to us as Christians to stand on the word and stand and represent the kingdom of God. Because in the last days, every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess. And if you ain't done what you're supposed to do, guess what? You're going to be condemned. And that's what the scripture says. Now, I only wanted to cover a couple of points because this is a very simple process. And it talks about, I'm going to look at three things. Who do we evangelize to? What do we say? And when should we evangelize? And the Bible makes it very clear. It talks about how true Christians, how we are supposed to just stay on the word. The Bible has all the information that we need to do what we do. You know, Matthew 28:19, we just read that, where it says, go and give the word. Mark 16:15 says, go into all the world and preach the good news to all creation. And it makes it clear that what we should do it for everybody, and we can do it everywhere. What do we say? Well, what I have to do is I don't want to, you know, push people off. I got to let people understand that we have all sinned and fall short of the glory of God. You see what I'm saying? That's Romans. And 3:23. But then in Romans 6:23, he said, for the wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life for Jesus Christ. So guess which one I'm going to deal with? You see what I'm saying? I don't have to keep trying to go up in my mind thinking about what needs to be done when the word says what you need to do. Keep it simple. See, what I think ain't what it is. And my problem is the way I react and the way I respond to what I think. So just trust in the Lord. And we need to understand that salvation is found in Jesus. That famous scripture, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And whosoever believes in him will not perish and have eternal life. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned already because he has not believed the name of God's one and only Son. Jesus is the only means of salvation. Not Buddha, not Allah. Jesus.
Right.
Acts 4 4:10-12.
Yes.
It is by the name of Jesus Christ.
All right.
Salvation is found in no one else. But there is no other name under heaven given to men by which we must be saved.
All right.
So please, don't get it twisted.
Yes.
Understand that you need to lean now to your own understanding.
Yes.
Acknowledge God and let him direct the path. You ain't got to be scared if you're a Christian, because 2 Timothy 1:7 says, I don't give you a spirit of fearfulness. I give you power, I give you love, I give you sound mind. So why did you keep going in that empty pit?
Yeah.
Stay on the word. Stay focused in the word. I know it's hard to watch what's going on in TV. I know it's hard to listen to the radio. If it gets like that, turn it off. Turn it off. Fall on your knees and ask God your understanding to give you what you need to get past where you need to be. Because the mission of the devil is to steal, kill, and destroy. But what he'll do first, he wants to separate and divide. You get what you get when you do what you do. If you don't do nothing, you'll expect nothing because you don't get it. Because the only thing that God does not follow is your free will. He respects you so much that he will allow you to do and be whatever you want to do and be. Because I'm a witness today. For 13 years, I did and been what I shouldn't have been doing. But I'm so grateful for these last 18 years, 5 months, and 3 days. And I told God, if you get me out of this, I'll do anything. Anything. I told this man last night, you ain't got to drive nowhere. Just call me. I've had enough. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. It ain't about that pain. It's crazy to think the pain has to outweigh the pleasure. Why? Why are we suffering when we have a Savior that suffered for us? Didn't you hear the man suffering? He hung on that cross. He was in severe pain. Suffered tremendously, and when he died, he folded the napkin and let us know, I'll be back. About the human ego. The human ego is easing God out. But see, I need to realize that God is about good order and direction.
Yes.
And this man told me last night, you need to go to Sunday school.
Well,
I started to pull over the highway and put it out. But because of the love of Jesus, process of life is that when we do go there, we don't go there as much, and when we go there, we don't stay there as long. It's all right to lose your mind for about 15 minutes. You know what I'm talking about? I go there all the time. Because see, I realize that I'm a human being and I suffer from having feelings and emotions. But see, I know today, just like I just said a few minutes ago, my feelings ain't the facts.
That's it.
But it's the fact that I do feel, and I have to learn how to see and be and do. Because the truth of the process is me.
Yes.
See, are you man and woman enough to look at what God has done for you?
All right.
You see what I'm saying? Because he brings you from a lifelong way. You see what I'm saying? And he has taught me how to love. And see, first love I had to have had to be for me. That's how you get the experience. How you gonna love somebody else if you don't love yourself? Where is your experience coming from? How do you know what love is? God is love. And he talks about it above. How can you say you love your fellow man that you see every day and treat like garbage and say you love God? You see what I'm saying? These folks in this ministry, we need some help. I'm willing to do whatever that needs to be done today. Because left to my own devices, I'm a problem. I realize that I am my worst enemy on any given day. And see, I have to look at the fact that the enemy is just looking to see where I'm weak at. See what I'm saying? Wherever you're weak at, guess who's going to be there? You know what I'm talking about? I got the devil. He get all in my car. You know what I'm saying? I don't even want to lock it up. Next thing I know, he's sitting right there. He don't want to buy no gas. I try to turn the radio on. He turned it off. I got it on 104.3. He want to listen to 105.7.
You know what I'm talking
about? He always shares. Always got something to say. And see, what I got to look at, I got to look at my track record. You see what I'm saying? See, my track record with him ain't good, but my track record with God is wonderful. Because he makes the way out of no way. He makes the impossible possible. But you got to believe him to receive him. So just for today, understand that because in 1 Peter 3:15, when it talks about where we should evangelize, it said, but in your heart, set apart Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give a reason for hope that you have. But do it. Do it. Check this out. Do it with gentleness.
Amen.
And respect.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
Don't grab them by the head, fall on the ground with them and say, if you don't believe this, I ain't going to let you go. You know what I'm saying? See, I love the fact that God gives me a choice. Because when I do it, and I know I did it, that's why I hurt so bad.
That's right.
I know I know bad it is. My mom never taught me bad it is.
Yeah.
Why do you keep doing the same thing? Boy, what's wrong with you? I be telling my son sometimes, boy, so I need to do a DNA test? Embrace the love. I mean, all you gotta do, action speaks louder than words. You know what I'm saying? You can see actions. You can't see words. So just for today, it's about considering the source. Why are we so concerned with what other people think? You know what I'm saying? It's not that hard. So in conclusion, this is what I'm gonna leave y'all with. We're living in a world that's full of chaos and sickness. And you know, just coming to the church is not enough. We as Christians, we have a responsibility to go out in the world and preach the gospel.
All right.
Be fearless. Be be enthusiastic. You know what I'm saying? We talk about the Jehovah Witnesses. We talk about the little boys on the bicycle with the Mormons. You see what I'm saying? But they on their job. They on their job. What are we doing? What are you doing? Let's get real. It ain't we. What you doing? How you represent? This is the challenge. Everybody sitting here right now, praise somebody next service. And let's see what it looks like. You see what I'm talking about? That's what it's about. Let's show up. That's all. Don't talk about it. Be about it. Catch the vision.
All right.
Go evangelize. Don't wait. Because, you know, in Revelation, it talks about how in the last days, there's going to be 144,000 Jewish evangelists. And you don't have to wait for that time. If you do what you need to do right now, you ain't got to worry about the last days. Because you're going to be covered. Because Jesus has already paid the price.
All right.